Hey, what's up? It's Jason Newman. I'm the senior news editor for RollingStone.com, and we are here with Tim Heidecker, Greg Turkington.
Hey, guys.
We're going to be talking about music, some of the biggest albums happening right now. And first off is the Chainsmokers, popular EDM duo. And their new album, obviously, as you guys know, Memories Do Not Open. So we'll get your thoughts on that.
Yeah,
we're doing the new movies.
We're here to promote our show Decker Season 5, which we worked very hard on. Music, yes, we can talk about music. What was the name of the group?
The Chainsmokers.
Okay.
Reminds me of Chain Mail, like in the new King Arthur movie, if you haven't seen that one yet. It's very good with Jude Law.
What I love about the Chainsmokers is I got a chance to work with them. I was doing a DJ set a few months ago in Dubai. Mm. And, you know, some of the best BPMs I've heard. The BPM settings were just dialed in perfectly. Yeah. And I think they were at 150 or something like that. But
so you would say it was a certain amount of beats per minute?
The BPMs were perfect.
How many frames per second in a 35mm film? Do you have any idea?
Are we converting to beats per minute?
No, I'm just asking you to make. I think it's to help put some interesting things on the show.
35?
I'm saying how many frames per second.
Oh. Let's move on. There's idols out there. People have idols. People have people they look up to.
Humphrey Bogart, Casablanca, and the Maltese Falcon, right. Treasure of the Sierra Madre.
Right. But I'm saying like music, like, you know, there was Elvis. There was
who's actually
Alice.
A good actor too, and movies like Charo, Change of Habit. Whereas later movies that were more dramatic movies, the earlier ones were more musicals. Like
we're talking
Loving
about
you,
speaking
King
of music.
Creole.
We're talking about music here, so just
well, I'm talking about them. Musicals.
You know, every generation has the icon. I think you know you have Elvis in the 50s,
James Bond in the 60s.
No,
and in the 70s.
No, I'd say Jim Morrison, Jimi Hendrix. 70s, you have
Luke Skywalker, Princess Leia.
I'm thinking like Alice Cooper. Those kind of guys, Peter Frampton.
James Bond again in the 70s with
80s,
Roger
Billy Moore. Idol. 90s, Kurt Roder.
Pierce Brosnan took over the role.
Roder.
Who's the guy from Pearl Jam? Kurt
Eddie
Roder.
Eddie Vedder.
Eddie Vedder from Pearl Jam, 90s. And then now we have Chainsmokers.
Right.
When we're talking about Chainsmokers, let's give a little respect to the great Keith Richards.
Sure.
Who was sort of a famous Chainsmoker.
Or George Burns, who's chain-smoking cigars.
Right.
Kind of different.
I love Keith Richards more than probably anybody.
Pirates of the Caribbean was based on him.
Yeah.
Oh, it goes back. There's a very popular singer named Ed Sheeran. Mm-hmm. The album out called Divide.
It's not that popular because I've never heard of him.
He's pretty big.
I don't think so.
Yeah. The album
is he in any movies?
He's been in videos mostly. They're not.
That's
they're more
not
short.
Not the same
films.
Thing.
But they're films.
It's teeny bopper music. It's teeny bopper music, you know, and I love it.
And Paul McCartney is a guy that's in the Pirates of the Caribbean 7, but also had a big music career, but also was in movies like Give My Regards to Broad Street, Help, and a few others.
A lot of people are talking about the fact that Ed Sheeran's album is a divide sign.
I haven't heard anyone say that.
A lot of people.
Is it what sign?
It's a division sign versus actually saying divide.
Well, I think, you know, there is a division amongst the Ed heads out
there. There's a division right here between people that are interested in that and people that are not. With this is the group that's not interested because I thought we were here to talk about movies, not these guys that are friends of yours that you're trying to push their music.
Right.
People want Ed to be something he's not. You know, they want to put him in a box. And I've been
I
want to
put him in a box.
Like, excuse me. I've gone through that myself with the Dakar stuff where my band, you know, we keep pushing the limits about what music can be. But I have a prediction that the fan base, half of them, if not
the ones that are not dead.
There's going to be a contingent group of the fan base that goes, I'm out.
Do you find yourself struggling with
mental health issues?
Do you find yourself struggling with fans who want the old stuff versus the new? How do you reconcile those two worlds?
Or that want movie talk instead of music talk.
Right. It's a hard reconciliation. I know you guys are big hip-hop fans.
Mm-hmm. No.
I don't care for the rap talking. I think it's if you got an opportunity to make music, you got to sing. You don't just talk.
I did like Poetic Justice with Janet Jackson and Tupac Shakur as a popcorn classic, and you can get it very easily on videotape. We actually have 3 copies in my archive.
Tupac was obviously a big actor as well. What was your kind of take on Pac as an actor?
I think Juice he should have done more acting and less of the music. Nobody really cared about the music, but the films are very good. Gridlocked was another one with Tim Roth.
No one knows the real name, though.
It was a pseudonym.
A lot of actors, George Burns' real name wasn't George Burns. Groucho Marx is probably a pseudonym.
And the last album I want to talk about was Drake, Canadian rapper, singer. Mm-hmm. He's been around for about almost a decade now.
Oh.
He had an album called More Life.
Don't care
Huge
about
album.
That.
A lot of people were debating in the music community over whether it was a mixtape or an album.
I'm sure Drake's gone through this where you have one song and then the record label's like, you gotta fill out this with more songs. Yeah. And say, how many songs can you have? So you do remixes, you do different versions, cut downs, longer versions, EDM mixes.
Remakes, like a movie.
Remakes. Mm-hmm. But the truth is, how do you get more songs?
His album's like 25 songs.
Well, I'm sure most of those are just iterations of the same thing.
No, they're all different.
Okay. I don't know how he has the time to do all that. We went out to the desert to do sort of a sabbatical where we were going to write, you know, the record. And we were out there for 6-7 days and not one tune or lyric came to us.
At all. It's kind of like a reverse of how a lot of bands do it.
Yeah, it was the worst sort of writer's block I've ever experienced.
I know the Eagles famously went out west to Joshua Tree to do peyote, and from that came out with, I believe, the band name, the Eagles, and they wrote some songs on that. Was there any?
We were using this now fully discredited THC vape system that was working really wonders for me. Creatively, but not during the desert period. The dosage was all wrong, and it actually put me out for most of the time we were out there. I was kind of anesthetized, fully under, you know, not even dreaming. And we got out there Monday morning and started vaping, and Thursday came to.
If you had to pick one album throughout all of music history that you would say is the biggest influence on you right now, what would you...
Soundtrack to Spies Like Us.
It's also Paul McCartney.
Yeah, he did the title song. Yeah.
Well, thank you guys for joining us to talk about music with Tim Heidecker, Greg Turkington.
Well, it's supposed to be movies.
Well, and also I just want to shame you a little bit because this format is proprietary to the On Cinema Productions, TCH Productions, and you just can't go willy-nilly out there and start doing movie shows or review shows without permission from our corporation. And I'm going to grant you this opportunity here.
Appreciate
that. But if you pursue this technology or this format, then we're going to have absolute. We're going to have a big problem here. I don't want to make this a big thing. I don't want to be.
But you are.
Well, I'm getting it on the record, you know, because. Yeah. Is a proprietary technology, it's a proprietary concept. The intellectual property is mine and mine alone. And you're playing a very dangerous game if you continue to pursue it. Okay? I don't want to end on that kind of
this is
negativity.
More this movies, is Jason less Newman, music. Senior news editor of Rolling Stone, with Tim Heidecker and Greg Turkington. Thank you guys for joining us.
Okay, good luck to you.
Thank you.